Hey everyone, Eric with Upton Bass here. A call, another luthier tip. A call we've get often, and actually a call I just got the other day, was someone who did a string change, changed all his strings, and was afraid that the strings were defective because the instrument was dull. It was dead. It didn't have the sustain and ring that it used to have. And I asked him, you know, did you change, you know, we kind of went through a bunch of just troubleshooting things, and I came up across the, did you change all the strings at the same time? Yes, was his answer. Obvious question, make sure your soundpost didn't fall. His soundpost was still up. And I told him, check the tailgut and how the tailgut is coming up over the saddle. And I said, I suspect you're probably kicked way off to the side or it's splayed really wide. And that's what he came back with. He goes, yep, you got it. He says it was kicked to the side and it was really wide. You know, one side had fallen off the little decorative recurve that we put on it to come back down to the arching. So when he put everything right, recentered it and called me back, he's like, yep, everything's back to normal. I got that ring. I got that sound that I had before. It's an easy little thing to screw up during string change, but the reason of the video is not solely for you to be aware of something that you gotta watch when you're doing a string change. It's actually a fun little experiment you can do on your own bass, provided you have a flexible tailgut and not one of those coat hanger wire ones. If your tailgut is a flexible type, if you think your instrument is too sustainy, too ringy, detune your instrument and splay these out wide. Almost artificially wide. It'll correct itself a little bit under tension, but try splaying them out wide and see what that does. By hampering the tailpiece from rocking, you're gonna kill some overtones and you're gonna kill some sustain. Some people like that, some instruments like that. On the flip side, if you think your instrument's a little dull, just kind of dead, you hit the note and it doesn't keep ringing after that, try pinching this. Detune the strings a little bit, pinch this in as narrow as it'll go, and then bring it back up to pitch and see what that does for the tone on your bass and the way you're playing it. You may like it. You may want it more ringy and more overtone-y. So it's a fun little experiment you can do, and if you don't like it, you can just put it back to where it was. Oftentimes there's impressions on the ebony from where it's been sitting for so long. So getting back to where it was before, not a hard thing to do. So it's a simple change you can do at home. You don't have to take the strings off the bass to do it. You can just severely detune it. Obviously, make sure your soundpost doesn't fall. Put the instrument on its back. You know, take some obvious precautions so that you don't have to go into the luthier and say, hey, I dropped my soundpost. But give it a try. Play with it. Take a look at your tailgut. See where your tailgut is. It's a fun little experiment you can do on your bass today and see if it makes a change. All right, thanks. Bye.